everybody, listen, just in case you didn't know. Here is the main ingredient, it really changed my life. A life full of iniquity and very deeply stained. But I found my hope at Calvary, flowing from my Savior's vein. You ask me if I think it'll work, I tell you I don't think. Cause I know, I know, I know, I know. Life saving, life changing, it covered me and I tell you I know. Hey!
Kick it off. Welcome to another edition of Strengthening the Body TV, a broadcast which airs every week right here on this local station, in which we sit down and talk about the issues of life with various pastors, leaders from the community, men and women of God, those that have pertinent information to share with us as we strengthen the body. My brothers and sisters, you hear every week, I declare the same thing. I don't want to keep coming to church and going home, coming to church and going home, coming to church and going home. I'm ready for results. And so every week we come back with you and thank you for joining us again. Tonight I want to remind you to go to the website www.strengtheningthebody.org. Click on the link on the left that says STB TV. Email me the information of those that you would like to see come and sit in this hot seat and talk about the issues. This is a broadcast. It's a talk show that's geared toward you. This is about you. It's not about us. It's about Christ. And it's about the Christ in you. And so we welcome you again tonight to the set. You've seen us. We record from various areas around the country. And we broadcasted from Arizona. And that was a wonderful broadcast. And we're back here in Henderson, North Carolina, Progressive Harvest Fellowship Church, who is sponsoring this program along with others. And we want to say thank you once again for joining us. Tonight, let's get right into STB TV. That's why you tuned in. And I want to welcome to the set tonight. I want to welcome with us here a good friend, a close friend of ours, one that has been chomping at the bit to get here and to talk to you, my brothers and sisters. He is the pastor of Trinity Worship Center in Oxford, North Carolina. He is an awesome man of God, a preaching machine. He is none other than Pastor Reginald Tyrone Harris, and we want to welcome you, Pastor, to Strengthen the Body TV.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you for coming to join us, and we want you to just sit back tonight and just talk to us about the things of life that will help strengthen us. So, Pastor, first of all, before we really get started, take a little time, tell us who you are, where you're located, something about Trinity Worship Center.
Well, Bishop, we're located in the wonderful city of Oxford. They have a tendency to call it the Great Big City.
The Great Big City.
I think that's somewhat facetious, but we're located in Oxford, North Carolina. We have a wonderful ministry going on. My wife and I started it about 4 years ago. Mm-hmm. And so we've just been trying to make sure that we produce disciples.
All right.
I once had a conversation with the pastor, and he shared with me his concern about me starting a church. This was not in Oxford, this was somewhere mm-hmm. else. He shared with me his concern about starting a church, and he said, my concern is that you're going to take my members. And I told him, I said, you know, one thing I don't want to do is I don't want to recycle church people.
Okay.
I said, I believe that there are enough individuals out there who don't know the Lord, mm-hmm. That we can get this gospel out, that we can teach them what it is to be saved mm-hmm. and love the Lord. And so I said, I'm not concerned about stealing your church members.
All right.
I'm concerned about reaching those that are truly lost.
All right. I think that's good. I think that's something that we can coin that phrase. I'm not interested in stealing your church members. What about stealing Satan's church members?
Yeah, what about stealing his church members?
That's right. Church members. Pastor, you, in your initial comments, you kind of triggered something, a question that I would like to ask, and maybe we can talk about this because it's a struggle that's out there. You mentioned that you and your wife started the ministry four years ago. There are plenty of pastors that are out there that they stepped into a church that mm-hmm. was ready-made for them. They mm-hmm. stepped into a church that was already established for 129 years, and they already had 75 members, mm-hmm. and they already had a nice bank account. But for the rest of us that had to plan a church or dig out a church, Can we talk tonight about some of the struggles? Maybe the people need to know about the struggle of being a church planner.
Yes, sir. You know, Bishop, when me and my wife, we felt the call to start Trinity. At the same time, I had some friends whispering in my ear saying, you know, you just need to, you know how preachers are. Preachers mm-hmm. love, Doc, you don't need to do that, Doc. Doc, you need to get a traditional church, Doc. Uh-huh. And so I was torn which road do I take. Mm-hmm. As the Lord continued to deal with me, I felt the need to be, I like this word, become an establishmentarian.
Okay.
I felt the need to establish Trinity because I want to get away from church as the norm.
Okay.
Now don't get it wrong. We're not preaching some sick, twisted gospel, uh-huh. or we're not preaching anything that's mm-hmm. strange.
Right.
We still believe in the same truths as a traditional church. Mm-hmm. We just believe in a move of the Holy Ghost. Mm-hmm. Not to say that the Holy Ghost don't move in traditional churches.
Right.
But what I am saying is that I want to get away from the traditional mindset of the people in the traditional churches
right.
that hinders the move of the Holy
right.
Ghost.
Right.
As me and my wife started, we said, well, we can either have one of two fights. Mm-hmm. We can either have the fight of getting people to come so that we can pay the light bill and the rent, or we can have the fight, this family versus this family, this deacon versus this deacon, uh-huh. this clique versus this clique. Mm-hmm. And I think we decided to take the easier of the two fights.
Okay.
I would rather sacrifice, let me say it like
that. Okay.
I would rather sacrifice some of the stuff that I would have to do in order to support the church, mm-hmm. then go in into a church that was already established. And again, there's nothing wrong with taking a church
right.
that's already established.
Totally understand.
But this was a personal decision that I made. Mm-hmm. I would rather make the sacrifice of me struggling to pay the light bill versus me fighting for 5 years before I can get anything even established in the church.
Right. Well,